First, as I announced, he said, thank you very much for letting us come. I'll let my other winners and my colleagues introduce
them. Hi, I'm Merrifield. Let's
turn that, Wolf, let's turn there for a second and get a good picture.
Thank you.
Mr. President, I'm Cynthia Parton Dowling.
Nice to see you.
How are you?
Just fine, thank you.
Donna Ryder from the State Department.
Good to see you.
Mr. President, Captain Michelle Coleman.
Nice to see you.
President, I'm Denise Marshall.
Nice to see you.
Hi, Mr. President, Lisa Rogers from the State.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Mr. President, I'm ready for a very recent.
Just Maria filed back, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on the other side.
I'm pretty proud that one alumnus and two of you belong to us.
Could we move forward on the other side? Number two, Maria, right there.
Back up.
We're going to take, ladies. There we go.
Sorry, I hope I don't look higher. Shall we?
Before you go, I couldn't get counter this occasion. I couldn't resist. I like to tell you we're all great. True story, an accident. Man lying there, obviously injured in a crowded gathering. The man looked up to do what he did. She stepped neatly back. And then pretty soon she tapped him on the shoulder. And she said, when you come to that part about calling the doctor, I'm right here. My favorite story.
Oh, my collection. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
The beginning of mine. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank you, Mr. President.
You tell with a short time.
Thank you, Mr. President.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. President. This is truly a dream come true.
Oh, I think it's a pretty good dream for me, too.
Thank you very
nice
much.
To see you.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
You've
been
selected.
Well, thanks for having me.
Thank you, Mr. President.
I'll spare you the speech about Foreign Service retirement I was supposed to give
you. All right.
Chandler.
Nice to meet you, Mr. President. Thank you for seeing
us. Nice to see you.
Thank you. This is Mr. Chandler.
Hello. Jim Rockets.
How are you, Mr. President?
Nice to see you. Thank you for all the help that you've been.
Well, we're trying to be of help, but
you have been.
We're typical Americans. We're in this together.
Can we get a group picture here?
Thank you. Thank you. I think you should. I think you should.
Thank you.
That's fine.
Right here, Jim. Thank you.
I've already verified that it's the best film in the world.
Yes, sir. I just want to make sure they're shooting a lot of it.
That's right. They do a fine job. May I say a word about the world situation as we see it? I don't want to take a great deal of your time, but Eastman Kodak first.
And that was all. I'm doing the right things. Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Things to do.
That's good.
We'll keep working. I don't know
well,
it
yes.
Sounds like Japan.
Yes.
Mr. President, may I present Mr. Paul Gottlieb,
and
President
Mr.
Labor.
President.
Hello there.
Very nice to see you, sir.
Well, it's good to see you.
So I step right here.
Yes. And this is Bob Morton, my editor.
Hello. Nice to see you.
And this is Judith Michael, the designer of the book.
Good to see you.
And this is Beverly Fazio, who was the assistant to Bob in the book. And Mr. Gottlieb wants to do a little presentation.
It's just a brief presentation, sir. This is a specially bound copy of Mike's book. It's given us enormous pleasure to work with him on what we think is a really significant project, a record of your administration and others who have been here in Washington at the time and present. It is the only book I've ever published, which was obsolete
Thank you. Well, I'm very proud and pleased to have this. Thank you.
Very glad, sir. You'll find here where the ribbon is. But there is a portrait of yourself.
Just in case.
You didn't forget your.
There you are. Well, thank you very much.
This particular company is unique.
Yes, I understand that. I'm very honored. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, especially for taking the time for seeing us. I appreciate it.
Did you ever think when you started with that first box camera that you...
He's come a long way.
Well,
all right. Thank you very
thank
much,
you, sir.
Appreciate
thank
you.
You.
Okay.
Sir, have some
more. See you. Oh,
ladies.
Pins.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Have to have some souvenirs.
That's very nice.
How very nice.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Okay, please.
We hope to see you.
I was just looking up there to call your attention to something, since the same thing is on all of those. You'll notice which way the eagle's head turns.
Yes. To the left.
To the olive branch. Harry Truman did that. Up until then, the eagle's face was always turned to the arrows. After World War II, he
made
the switch.
Okay, thank you, sir. I really appreciate it.
Yes.
Okay,
thank
you. Bye. We'll hope to see you later at the opening.
Yes, be there tonight. Look forward to it.
Good afternoon.
Bye.
How are you? Good to see you. Good to see you. Meet the number one coach in the country. That's good one. Lavell Edwards.
Hello. Good to see you.
Congratulations.
There's football from the number one football team in the country.
Well, thank you.
From the number one coach.
Jacket for Mrs. Reagan.
I've got to get that jacket.
We'll send one to you that's about his face.
You'd be very pleased to have that.
Well, thank you.
Well, I'm very pleased to have this. I'm honored.
As you can imagine, we're pretty proud of this team, this coach.
Yes. The only major school with an untied. I was telling a favorite fellow around here, Dick Ridland, I didn't play on that kind of thing. If we broke even, we thought it was pretty much. But I want to tell you something that I think the coach would appreciate. I learned an awful lot from a football coach, Ralph McKenzie. At age 90, no, I'm sorry, it isn't 90, but it's still in the upper 80s. But he is still... It's not as if it's out on the field every afternoon with them. But we were a small school, 250 students, co-educational back in those Depression days. The average team that we played was from the schools about 10 times our enrollment or more. And so it was always an uphill battle. And one day, some of us went to him and said, you know, come on. It'd be a lot of fun to win more games than we do. Why can't we have a schedule and we name it? Poverty-stricken schools that we might play. And he said, yes, I could do that. But he said, tell me, even if you had beaten, he said, years from now, he said, would you remember with any great joy that you beat one of these two schools, which I won't name? Or he said, would you like to remember more that you played against the kind of team that you're playing? And we looked at each other. We knew he was right.
That's it.
We learned a little lesson, and it was true. Could I be redshirted?
Yes.
That's for sure.
They have a son that plays with their son and their husband on the team. Can you find his name?
No, it's nice to have you back.
I'm particularly proud of that. I taught there for 25 years. I taught at BYU for 25 years working in Congress.
Tell me something, dude. Is he just made for this?
Yes. What they did, everyone signed on the
was that massive way. Yes, then that way that we've had them, yes, you know, where the old autograph of all these that comes off. We made one up and gave one to each one of the players.
Because I played in one of the first night games in football.
Is that right?
And when James Duncan University, where Paul Musil,
yes,
the Bears played. I spent 60 minutes opposite him. He outweighed me 100 pounds.
Undergraduate.
How are you?
And his wife, Deb. Undergraduate in law school.
There are no secrets about it, particularly. As you look around the table, you'll see many friends. And I wonder if, while the cameras are clicking, if we couldn't just go briefly around so that the names and organizations of the people are made known in your presence. Ed, why don't you kick it off?
Patch over to your office.
My name is Anderson, the Hoover Institution.
I'm Tom Donahue with the American Trucking Association.
Les Winkowski with the American Enterprise Institute.
I'm Roger Semerov with the Brookings Institute. Martin Anderson, former governor of Brookings. Glenn Kent, Governor Pete Park, Secretary of State.
We are
at
Jane
O'Hudson
Institute.
Morgan Torrey, the Institute for Research on Economic Management.
Herb London with New York University and the Hudson Institute.
Tom Bell, Hudson Institute. But hiding in the back there is Terry Sleaze, who you know well,
the
State Foundation.
Well, Tom, I thank you, and I think all of you here, members of this committee.
Mr. President.
Mark, hi.
How are you, sir?
Well, good to see you.
Terrific.
I just turn around here, Will.
Thank you very much. I'm so excited. There's a couple of your favorite for my campaign. Could we get a picture of your desk together?
Yeah.
Would that be on position?
No.
Sit over here.
Oh, all right.
Thank you. Okay. I feel so strongly that the next 10 years really is such a transitional time in history, and the things that happen will have such a lasting effect, and I just want to be part of process and part of the debate. I'm so excited. I've already raised $100,000 on the board and built a coalition of support that's never been put together in a congressional district before. Thank you, sir.
Good enough.
I want to urge you to keep up on the Star Wars and don't let it ever,
oh,
ever.
No,
please.
I'm not. We're going to stay with it. Oh, yes. So it'll hold some papers down in your desk. That's your
thank you so much.
All right.
I'm so
all right.
Thank you very much. One last thing I just want to say on my way out is that so many of us are sure hoping that you'll find a way to keep Jim Kirkpatrick in the administration.
I'm going to try my very best.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
So wonderful to see you. We'll see you up at the CFA reception later on this afternoon.
Okay.
Thank you again.
You bet.
See
you.
Bye.
Jay,
hi. How are you?
Mr. President. I'd like to introduce you to Dr. Merrifield. Yes, how are you doing?
Very
well. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
I think you ought to get a family picture.
His wife was his mother. His daughter Nancy.
Hello there. Well, why don't we come here?
How do you want to?
I think that that's
that right.
Yes.
Okay. Things of what other people have said, for example, Martin Van Buren,
had to say about the train and how a train going 15 miles an hour just destroys civilization. And I think my favorite is Napoleon. Robert Fulton tried to sell him a steamboat. And Napoleon said, "You're trying to tell me that you can have a ship that will sail against the current and against the wind by building a bonfire under its deck? I won't listen to you."
That's hard to convince people of new facts, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm glad you enjoyed those. Well, I have, and I'm looking forward to using them.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, thank you.
All right. Well, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Sheila Cast is new with ABC.
Hi.
Hi. Whoops, nice to meet you.
You kind of slammed that way.
I'm sorry.
All right.
Nice to meet you.
Well, it's nice to see you. Steve Shepard.
How do you do, Mr.
Hi.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
Well, pleasure. Miles Benson.
Hello, Mr. Pleasure.
All right. Patricia Wilson. With Rorty, she's in Ralph Harris.
Fine, thank you.
Let's see.
Hi there, sir.
Hello there.
Hi, Richard.
Mr. Mullen. George DeLama.
Hi.
The Chicago Tribune, Mr. President.
Well, nice to meet another Cubs fan.
Well, close to the old home territory, too.
Dale Nelson, he's the new AP.
See you.
Alessandra Stanley.
Jim Connors.
See, how are you?
It's a pleasure to have
to see you. Now I bet we ought to have a group. Are you all going to begin to be rivals again? Well, let me see. Roughly the middle, must be. Oh, dear.
Are you doing anything special to get ready for the inaugural? More weightlifting?
Oh, I do that every day. When I get through at the end of the day, I prepare. That's the first thing. 15 minutes.
It's going to be pretty cold out there. Are you going to wear your long johns? Fresh layer of snow. It would look pretty, but it might gum up the works.
I'd rather have the green grass. Everybody was worrying about a late Christmas and so forth out in California. I just love it green.
Maybe they give a palm tree.
Bench press. Huh?
How much do you bench press?
Oh, I don't do that kind. Probably I know that's got a gym out in Los Angeles. And we have, I've got some equipment up there, the Nautilus equipment. And it's he gave me two sets of exercises for already days, muscles. I never thought at my age that you could still build muscle, but I'd had to have a little alteration on the clothes. I'd added 2 inches around my chest.
Congratulations. Yeah.
You going to watch the game Sunday, sir?
Huh?
You going to watch the game Sunday?
Well, I don't know. I haven't seen the full schedule yet of all the activities that begin very shortly, so I don't know whether I'm going to have time to. I'd like to.
President said
I know I'm going to have to flip the coin, aren't I?
Yep. He said today if he makes it through the inaugural, the 4 years will be easy. Just get through the inaugural, he'll get a job.
Who are you rooting for? Who are you rooting for?
Well, by finding this job, I can't.
But we're not supposed to quote you today. So. You can test us now.
Well, I am from California.
Not again.
I read somewhere that you watched an Australian film at Camp David called Father.
Watch what?
An Australian film called
Yes,
Father.
Yes.
Camp David, did you enjoy it?
And that's about the only place we get to see movies anymore, as we run them up there. Yes, very much.
Have you seen other Australian films?
What?
Have you seen other Australian films?
Yes, the man from, is it Stony River?
Snowy.
Snowy River, yeah.
Snowy River.